Do you like to create a dim date or calendar table in Power BI using DAX? Watch this video up to the end and act like a professional. Hello everyone, Shab is back with another interesting video. And today, I'm going to teach you how to create a dim date table in Power BI using DAX. If it's the first time you're watching my video, don't forget to hit the subscribe button to get the notification for the new upcoming videos. Stay tuned. If you followed my channel, you probably watched another interesting video published last year about creating a dim date in Power BI using mPower Query. The link is available here on top right corner. Today I'm going to teach you another method to create a dim date table in Power BI using DAX. Indeed, a date dimension table in Power BI is a crucial element for effective time-based analysis, reporting, and visualization. It simplifies date-related calculations, provides easy filtering options, and improves the overall usability of your Power BI reports and dashboards. Let's see how to create it. First, from the Modeling tab, click on New Table. Here you can see a new table created on the data field on the right-hand side. And also you can write the DAX code here to create this table. For simplicity and your understandings, I described a simple method to add columns one by one. But I recommend you use a complete script to create whole the table at once. If you are interested to get the script, please comment below this video and I will send the complete script to you. So, I name this table as dimDate and equal to, then I write calendar and open parenthesis. You can see Power BI automatically shows us we need to insert the start date and end date with a comma separation. Here, I assume we need a dim date from 1st of January 2020 up to the end of December 2025. To insert a start date value in DAX, I need to use date function, and inside parentheses, I insert year, months, and day of the desired date. I do the same process for end date. So here you can see now we have a date column. It is very important to mark your dim date as a date table. So from the table tools menu, I click here on mark as date table and then choose the date column we created earlier. Now it's the time to create the next required columns. What we need to do is to press on New Column and then write the column name and the DAX formula on how to create it. We need to repeat this process for all columns. So, to speed up the process, I just show you each column name and the DAX code you need to insert for the required information. You can just pause the video or decrease the speed to write the code and watch the video again to learn everything step by step. The first column is date ID, which is equal to format, open parenthesis, our date column, and then comma, and inside the double quotations write YYYYMMDD, and then close the parenthesis. This column is useful when we join our date table to other facts and dimensions coming from SQL databases. Next column is year, which is equal to year, and inside the parentheses, insert our date column. For a start of the year, we need to write date, open parenthesis, year, open parenthesis, our date column, close parenthesis, comma, one, and then close the parenthesis. For end of year, I write date, open parenthesis, year, open parenthesis, date column, close parenthesis, comma, 12, comma, 31, and then close the parenthesis. To create a month column, I need to write months, and inside the parenthesis, insert the date column. To have a start of month, I simply write a start of month, open parenthesis, and our date table from dim date, and close parenthesis. To have end of month, I write end of month, and inside the parenthesis, insert the date column from dim date. To extract number of days in the month, just write this DAX code. To have year month number, I insert this value. Int, open parenthesis, format, open parenthesis, date column, comma, and inside double quotation, YYYYMM, and then close all the parentheses. And to have year month name, I write format, open parenthesis, date column, comma, and inside double quotation, I write YYYY-MMM, and close parenthesis. To have day number, I write day, and inside parentheses, I insert the date column. To insert the day name, I write format, open parenthesis, our date column, comma, and inside double quotations, I write D for four times, and then close the parenthesis. And to have the date name short, I write format, open parenthesis, date column, comma, and inside double quotation, this time I insert D for three times, and then close the parenthesis. You can see by creating this column, we have the short format of the day names. To create day of week, we need to write this DAX code. This code helps us to define Monday as the first day of week. If Sunday is the first day, easily write weekday and inside the parentheses insert the date column. To have day of year, we can write this DAX code. As you can see, we could easily create a dim date table with the defined columns. If you need to change the start date and end date, easily click on the table name and the DAX code will open up for you, and you can change these values. These columns are the essential columns we need in a dim date table. However, there are a wider range of columns available. that you can add to complete your dim deck table. All these DAX codes are available in a text file. If you're interested to have access to this DAX script, please comment below this video and I will come back to you with the link to download the script. And easily, you can just copy and paste the whole DAX script and have all required columns in a moment.
This is how easily you can create a dim deck table using DAX in Power BI. If you enjoyed this video, please like and share it and subscribe to the channel to get a notification for the new upcoming videos. Have a good day, all Power BIers.